If you have a folder full of photos on Google Drive and you want to create a beautiful end of the year video for your class, I've got you covered. In this quick tutorial, I'll show you exactly how to create a student slideshow video using Canva. Fast, easy, and fun. So your pictures are already in Google Drive, and Canva makes it super simple to turn them into a polished video for your students that your families will love. So let's get started. The first thing you want to do is sign into Canva. They have a free account, which is wonderful. If you're an educator, you can use your school email, and you can get an educator account. That is basically a pro account, but it's for free. But the pro account is well worth the money. I think it's like $12.95 a month at this time. Let's start designing your slideshow layout. You can totally start from scratch, but Canva also has some really great templates already set up for slideshows. You're going to press create. Then when you press that, you can choose video, and you see that there are a lot of different video templates already for you. Make sure you're choosing one that is in landscape is what I would recommend. You can click videos, and then you can also search. So when I search, I'm going to go ahead and pick this one right here. It's the black, white, vintage film look wedding slideshow video template. So I'm going to click customize template. So now that I've chosen that, I want to upload my photos. So before we go any further, let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go over to uploads is one way. We can go to uploads, and when you do that, you can click upload files and upload them from your computer, or you can also go to apps. When you go to apps, just click right up here at the top, and you're going to search for Google Drive. And then this will connect your Google Drive account. It will prompt you to enter everything that you need to connect those two accounts. I've already done mine in the past, so mine should come up. It's just taking a while. But once it's in there, I think your pictures are going to be labeled under assets. So when you click assets, they should show up. Now, mine have been here all morning, so I'm hopefully that they will pop up, but right now you do see this. If it's not working, one thing that you could do is you could go to Google Drive and you could download those images to your computer and then upload them that way. But there is definitely a way that you can connect Google Drive to Canva. Once you've added your pictures to the slides, you can customize the layout, add text, and make it personal. You can add your own things manually. You can definitely use the templates that are here. If you change your mind about this design, you can always go to design and click templates, and then you can see other templates and search right there. You can also go to layouts, and when you see layouts, it gives you other suggestions. When you see this cloud image right here, that is just a image holder. We call it a frame in Canva, and so you're able to use that and just put in your own images in these types of places. Now that we're here, let's go ahead and show you how you can customize this to your own. You can change the background color to whatever color you prefer. So I already have my brands in here, and on the bottom when I click that one slide, I can press change all, and all of my slides have changed except I have two here. Then I can also do that with my font. If I have a certain font I like, I can go back and I can choose that font, and then again go down to the bottom and change all, and all of my fonts will be changed throughout my design as well. Now for this slide, you'll notice the first slide, if I right click, it just says replace background. So these are not using frames. These are just images that they have been able to drag over. So if I go to uploads, I can just drag over a photo or click on it, and it will go into my presentation. Now for these, I'm just going to go ahead and press shift and hold down and then delete all of these at the same time. And then again, I can click on my photos and I can bring them over. But if we go to slide 2 and I right click, it says detach image. Now I can click detach image and then I can press delete, or I could just click on it and press delete, and then that image has been detached from this frame. So then I can go into my photos, whether you're getting them from the Google Drive app or you're getting them from your uploads, and you can go to images, videos. If you have a different audio, you can go there. But then you're just going to scroll down and you're going to find the image that works for you, and then you can just put it right inside. Like, I did a project on Jimmy Carter, so I'm going to put him in there right there. And then here's another one. I can just slide it in and hover it in. It will go right into my design. You can duplicate your slides by right-clicking and press duplicate, and then you can easily come in and change things. Then you can add people's names. Again, you can change the color of the font so it's easier to read by doing that. Click this. And then again, it can change all. I can change all of those to that blue instead of the black in just one stroke. Now, another thing I like to do is I like to add animations, but I'm not very creative when it comes to animations, so I let Canva do that for me. So I'm going to go click Animate. I'm going to go to Instantly Animate All Pages in the style of your choice for Magic Animate, which is a pro feature, so you need to be in your pro account to do that. And then you can choose the style that you might like, and you can see the different styles they have. I really like Playful and Handmade. I'm going to use Handmade for this. And then if I were to watch my slide, my video, you can see that it's already been added and animated for me, and I don't have to do anything. The timing of this video. If you will see right now, the timing, it says 5 seconds. When you click on that, you can change that right up here. If you want to edit the timing, you can apply it all the same. Or so 5 seconds, you got to think about how many images you have in there, and you can adjust it with this, or you could just type in there and you can apply to all pages or not. It's completely up to you. You're in control. If you want to add music, Canva has a built-in library with free tracks. So let me show you how to add one or adjust the timing so it all syncs up. So what you would do is you would go all the way down to where it says audio, and you can go to your style that you like, and then you can add the audio that you want. You cannot use copyrighted audio in Canva. It will not allow you to. So it's really important that if you do upload something, you have permission to do that. You can go over here and you can play the things that you like. Maybe you want a happy children's tune, but notice that these are very short. So look at the timing that you have. You can put more than one in it as you want, but it is something to think about that you look at the timing. So I'm just going to click this one. I'm going to click this first, and then I'm going to click Happy Ukulele, and you can see that the video is down here. I can move that by just clicking and dragging, and then I can also, once this is done, I can do beat sync, and it will sync the elements in the animation to this. So if I press this here, I should be able to hear it. If you have a lot more templates that you want to add, again, you can add more music. So if I went in and I added more, I could just keep adding, but then I could add in more music. So I'm going to click on the end. So this one is over. I can click on the end and I can go up and find another sound, and I can just put it right there, and I can add more and add more, and you can see that we can even drag it out for however long you want. So you can do more than one audio. Once everything looks good, you're ready to export your video and share it. Then you can also go to share, and you can share this with a public view link, or you can also upload it to YouTube, but just the public view link is like that. Create public view link, and this is the link that's copied onto your clipboard, is the link that you can also share with your class. And it will be done there for you. And that's it. You now have a sweet, simple video that your students are going to love, and it's going to share those awesome memories. So if this has helped, please give it a like and share, and maybe even add a comment below. And want more tips like this? I'm always happy to help teachers work smarter, not harder. So check out my other videos or reach out if you need any help. And I'll catch you next time.